Hello and welcome back to another half of the shit tier character update of Let's Play Blade of Darkness. Huh.
Among the mountains of the Half Moon, on the pine-covered slopes of Nemrut, stands the Fortress of the Clouds, which guards the lands of Sarikan. In the castle is one of the keys to the tomb of the fallen warrior. For during the War of the Sword, the men of that place fought alongside their allies, the knights.
Ooh, the camera is weird at the beginning of this level. Anyway, here is the barbarian. He has his light armor, which is the highest he's ever gonna get, I think. Which basically just covered one of his arms with a metal thing. And as I mentioned in the dwarf update, there is this Doom Axe, which is completely overpowered. The other weapons do like 210, 170 or something damage, and this one does 530. Well, this is just the power rating, not the actual damage. But let's check how effective it is against a couple knights, even if I can get unstuck here. Jumping works, I guess. The knights in this level for some reason always were slightly a joke. At least until we get to the darker knights, because the normal ones, they don't even have poison weapons or anything. Okay, yeah, I could have done that better, but still. Two hits, pretty much dead. Alright, that was slightly against my own words that they are easy. I'll get better. Promise! Actually, you know what, I'll probably just not use the weapon that I'm not even supposed to be using at this point. Although my stamina permits me to use it, but I just kind of don't like it. It's slow and whatnot. Special moves with the axes are horrible. Although the sword does have this retarded thing where after you press attack and forward, you automatically do a special move, even though you just maybe want to break something and then walk forward. But no, the game wouldn't let you do that peacefully. No, of course not. They had to invent new ways of making the controls in this game garbage. I also appreciate the barbarian not turning towards the enemy he is locked onto in the middle of his own attack. There we go. That's how you deal with the guys. The barbarian is a character, when you play as him, you have to deal with half of his moveset being utterly useless. That's just something that you have to figure out when you play as him. Additional challenge, I suppose. And the other half of this moveset is occasionally useful, but kind of shittily tricky to use. Like as I said before, you have to wind up his attacks from way before you are even close to the enemy. And of course some of his attacks are just stupid that don't really hit people. Goddamn. And there's that, which I still, despite this being my second playthrough as the barbarian in like a couple months or so, it still trips me up every single goddamn time. Of course he is just slow with his attacks, even those that are supposed to be useful in combat, and it's just horrible all the way around. I don't think that's actually saying what I just said, horrible all the way around, all around. Interestingly enough, that move with the sword, albeit with the previous sword, not this one, worked very well against orcs and goblins, because they remained stunned by my first hit long enough to get hit by this and not be able to interrupt it. But the knights here are at least cooler than that, I guess. Alright, I think here is actually where we are supposed to go. If the barbarian can please, yes, thank you, grab the ledge. That guy is kind of half asleep. I should have done my super awesome slow as hell move, which I can never do. God damn it. There we go, that move. I can never do it because you have to press the second part really late. Like almost after his swing. The second input is left and right simultaneously. Courtyard key. Lever. Let's name everything you see. This is strange. I don't know why they did this sort of geometry. Oh well. Texture is repeating. Oh my god. Actually, come to think of it, these stones are also kinda like these particular ones with the vertical stripes all across them are also kinda cartoonish looking. This game has inconsistent art direction. And he always, well, oh, what am I even saying? Not always. Sometimes enemies just kinda look like they shit themselves when you kill them. Also, if there's one good thing about the knights, it's that they don't seem to retaliate immediately after being hit like some other enemies, so you can actually afford some of those slow moves against them. Or of course you can just time them right so that they hit the enemy as he approaches. Which is just one of those metagame kind of things. You wouldn't expect to have to deal with this kind of shit, like directly they pretty much the game challenges you to work around its terrible animations. And that's how the challenge with the barbarian is made. But I guess it's fair. Whoa, two arrows now. I seem to remember when I was playing this level as my barbarian last time in my playthrough before the let's play. Like every guy was pretty much dying in one hit, but I don't remember which weapon I was wielding or anything. I just remember that they were just a joke, a complete joke. Even more so than I'm making some of them look now. Maybe they were just dying in a couple of hits that were especially easy to deliver. Okay, don't you drink! I just noticed that he actually has a potion. Which I kind of want. Because I'm being close to perfect health to drink one. Wow. You can trust the barbarian to not hit anyone. If there is even slightly suboptimal circumstances, like slightly lower than you? No, your sword will just fly above their heads. God damn it. Do the move. Or don't. You know, whatever. Spamming time. Right, cannot truly get to those archers, but whatever. I guess they're cowards and they will leave because of that. Moral of the story, kids, just camp somewhere and the hero will be too lazy to get to you. Or I mean, unable to directly get to you and too lazy to waste all his arrows on you. Okay, that was effective. Halberd for the Amazon, I think. There's a bunch of ways you can go here. Also, that wind, I don't think it actually affects anyone's movement. It's just a visual effect. How does one's head get cut off by a vertical strike from above? Crust. Not even gonna bother with the crust. Okay, let's go down here first. If I remember correctly, going down these in order should be fine. Killer axe, I think that is for the dwarf, right? Probably is. Well, at least I showed it to you. Now, there was some sort of... Ah, right, right, there it is. So, I think in order to optimize my route here, I will first go down here. Actually, no, that was a terrible idea, but whatever. Yeah, these guys are kind of slow to aggro. No, don't do that. Thank God you can interrupt that accidental thing with a jump. Otherwise, I would be really much more pissed even than I am now. Okay. Here I will be in the future, actually. Yeah, I wanted to go the other way, actually, sorry. Because... there's just something to glance at if you go through here first. There's that Minotaur looking like he's eating that corpse. And if you jump through here, land here, he doesn't really react for a while and he is not taking any damage for that while. Finally he stands up and actually activates. And thankfully he is mercifully slow, so we can afford to do that move. If I can pull it off, because the controls are annoying. Did I say it enough times throughout this LP? I don't think some of you got it. Let me just repeat, the controls in this game are shit. And the guy's dead. Double sword, I don't think it's mine. No, it doesn't seem so. I don't think it's actually anyone's weapon, it's probably a universal one. No, I don't want a great mace. This guy doesn't have blunt weapons. This level though seems like it's got a lot of equipment for the dwarf. And we are here. Again. That guy's clueless, largely. I enjoy how before the enemies see you, they don't react to being hit. Woo! There goes his shield. And unfortunately we still have to go back again, because there is a path above that I don't think you can get from below. Maybe you can actually, but I want to risk it. This is a strange layout in here. Whoa! God damn it. Pressing the second input too early each time. This almost looks like there would be a secret, but I don't think there is a secret if you go. Well, actually, I don't think this thing above your head would allow you to even go there. But if this were a better game like Quake or Doom, that would be totally a secret. Alright, I think this was actually kind of pointless, because despite this looking like a place where you really want to jump across, you can really get to here just by climbing, goddammit, stop standing on air, but by climbing those crates down there. And in here there's a bunch of stuff which I don't even remember what it is. Amazon, dwarf medium, some shields. Cool. Nothing useful for me. This level really is fucked for a dwarf. Should have probably chosen the dwarf to beat this level, but I am going by thematic appropriateness more than anything else. Although some of you might disagree with me on my choices of, goddammit, don't, of thematically appropriate characters for the levels, but I feel like a barbarian storming like a mountain fortress is kind of cool. And the other character that would be remotely appropriate here would be, of course, the knight. Maybe. But the knight is kind of universal. But I am saving him for a Middle Eastern temple, because that reminds me of the crusade. Alright, finally we can actually proceed somewhere. There's a Z place again. The clueless knight was there standing. There's his blood still on the walls. Going here, there's another freaking Minotaur. How many can you have? Also, I'm kind of wondering if they're actually like tame, or if the knights are keeping them completely forcefully here. Because I mean, they're wearing a belt and some things on their arms, so... Whoa, holy shit, actually this one has a shit ton of health, I just noticed, especially compared to the first one, the previous one. So this one is much more serious in a way. At least he doesn't have that club that kills you in one hit that some later Minotaurs do. Minotaurs, whatever. He's a Minotaur! That's actually where I... what I remember each time I want to know how to pronounce Minotaur. He's a Minotaur! Okay. Let's fight! You know what, I'm tempted to see if he's slow enough for me to be able to do the Doom Knight, Doom Axe attack. See, the Doom Axe is there, he's level 18 special move, so this weapon will be relevant for a while. But I want to try use Shredder. I wonder how much damage it will do. If I can pull it off once again. Or if I can pull it off and connect it. A lot of damage, nice to know. So yeah, this weapon is OP. Don't even approach me, motherfuckers. Also, it's surprising that this doesn't eat up as much stamina as that other move the sword does, despite how much later this weapon is supposed to be, I guess. Wow, I actually managed to hit someone successfully with this move. That is something new. Well, I mean, someone who is usually not quite as slow as the mini bosses. Yeah. But why would you want a special move that is just pretty much a dial combo which you have no control over? That's kinda stupid. The only reason for anyone to use these moves is because they deal shit tons of damage. Obviously shit tons more than regular swings, but god damn it, stop! Only I am allowed to stun lock enemies, this is annoying, I hate you guys. Copper key now. Stop lagging, please. So yeah, this game is strange. And I think it was designed by people who were kind of strange. And now I think it's time to switch to the Black Knights. Yep. Cool. I will probably return for this full life potion later. That should have at least broken his shield, come on. Okay. Another good thing about the combos is that you can actually break them, so yeah. Still strange and awkward to use, but at least not dooming if you do it slightly wrong. Yeah, that of course is dooming, that stupid thing where they try to do an attack they shouldn't be able to do and then stay in one place and just heavily breathe for a while, which is all kinds of stupid. There we go, finally. Okay, still not gonna return for that potion though. Actually, there might be another one. I don't remember. There is some place around here, there is like a wall on the right that you can go through. A window perhaps. This here, alright. One of these chests actually contains something for once. Another full life potion. Nothing else in here. But it's kind of awesome to have two full life potions available now, if I can please escape. As I said, maybe I will go back. Well, I pretty much guaranteed that I will go back after I fight a couple more people that will almost kill me, but not quite. And after that, I will have nearly no health. Hopefully I won't have to race against the clock of my poison, because that is always stressful. I say as if it always often happens, which it actually kind of doesn't. I'm just imagining the situation. And this guy, I think that's 1000 HP potion. I wish I could throw something, like a boomer axe. Actually, I could throw my axe, but that guy would just drink his potion, that will be all. Okay, I count that as progress, because now his shield is damaged. God damn it, there goes my potion. Patience, patience, patience. Do the thing. Right, you know what? Whatever. Terrible show. Terrible show. Oh well. Now here is a almost hidden secret. I'm becoming slightly adequate at shooting arrows in this game. And I don't remember what is the horror down there. If there is any sort of horror down there, like a trap or anything. I'm going to light this torch and go down there with a torch, hoping there is no zombies or anything like that, and that I'm able to just proceed through and grab my rune, maybe, hopefully. Oh, right, I remember what's down here. I remember, there is actually a trap. You might even see it. As usual, you just kind of trigger it manually like that, and then run through. And that is always scary, but that's just three arrows or something. Even if they hit you, they don't do much damage. But the door closes, so I think the only way you can actually proceed here is to hit that button with a bow. Come on, man, I thought I hit that. There we go.
How the Avestas agreed to create a place where they would all live together, and how Ayana, the beloved daughter of the father, created in this world a beautiful garden filled with life, and how Angramanyu, the Prince of Darkness, visited his siblings and lived with them.
All right. Thankfully, none of the traps work after you pick up the rune, so that's all good. Let's see if I can scavenge some arrows. I can. One by one. Alright, that's enough. Wow, is it one of mine? Because it's goddamn huge. Doesn't look like one of mine. And right now I'm gonna run back for the potion. I'm gonna drink one. I said I'm gonna drink one. And hopefully I remember to speed this up. Alright, we're back here. I'm gonna keep using the Doom Axe, I think. Although it seems risky as hell, but whatever. God damn it, Barbarian. You could, you know, aim with your hits. Well, that was nice. So yeah, that's how properly done fights using the barbarian actually go. Slow and tedious, and kinda dumb. Okay, gonna deal with the archer first. Then I will go get this. Actually, I will not probably get anything there. I don't think there is anything here. Sharp axe, that's for someone else, I think, right? Right. Knight medium armor. I don't actually remember if our knight already has medium armor. I think he might have found it someplace by this level, but there are doubles, so whatever. Okay, now why am I here? What was I going to do? Oh, I remember what I was going to do. I'm gonna go grab another torch from down there. Maybe even that one, actually. Well, still on fire miraculously, but it's probably going to run out before I get to my destination. There is a dark, really dark place that might have something for a barbarian. I don't remember. I hope the torch doesn't... Fucking torch! Piece of garbage. Alright, I'll try using this one. Okay, maybe you're just not meant to get the torches up here. Oh well. That was a bust. Anyway, a dark place. Spooky dark place, not actually here. Here. Let's see, is there maybe a torch somewhere on the ground here that I can pick up and use? Yes, there is! Thank God! He's holding the torch in the least useful manner possible. I also happen to remember that there is a trap around here, and I think this is in that corridor. I don't know if it activates more than one time. Double edge. I had it before I threw it out. Actually, I still have it. What am I even talking about? Yes, I just dreamed of throwing it away, because the Doom Axe kind of makes it obsolete. Okay, let's find out if that trap can be activated multiple times. Too bad I can't see the edge of the... I think it might be here, so... Alright, let's hope it's one-time use. Yep, this trap was one-time use, so that's nice. I also appreciate how it actually can be triggered by just a small object flying through the trap corridor. And my torch is out. Wonderful. I have to navigate by the Great Hammer, that's probably for the dwarf. Navigate by the shiny bones on the floor. Skeleton here. And there we go, that's the destination. Nothing too good actually, sadly. Ice axe, which I think I will pick up because maybe it will light my way or something. Power portion, which for some reason I can pick up because actually I didn't know that I didn't have it. But now I have pretty much every potion available. Cool. And no, this axe doesn't light up the environment. Can I at least maybe do the attack? Yes, I can. Well, that's interesting. Okay, I don't remember that happening. Maybe that guy spawns when you take the axe, actually, because I definitely went in here before without... Or maybe when you take the potion. Why am I using this weapon? I definitely remember walking all the way up here and then escaping without any sort of enemies spawning because of that. Oh well, not a lot of problems. Sadly, he doesn't stay where I would like him to stay, which is anywhere in the dark, to light my way, because now I am kind of unable to see anything. Like whatsoever. Alright, here's the trap part. Okay. This is all news to me, that the skeletons appear. So it's kinda cool, I guess. I'm glad I took both of those things so they all spawned. Whatever actually triggers them. Okay, that was bad, but at the same time interesting. Whatever, here's the exit. And I was slightly stalling here actually, because down, if you jump off the bridge, in either of these courtyards, well, there's already skeletons down there. If you jump off this bridge in either of the courtyards, you get to the place where, like, when I was first playing through this game legitimately without modified files or cheats, and I was playing as the Amazon, Unholy Recess. And there's of course the Sacred Recess over there. This is the only place in the entire game that gave me trouble when I was playing as the Amazon. Thankfully it didn't give me trouble when I was replaying as the Amazon to get to her next level. But, you know, the Barbarian kinda sucks and doesn't have blunt weapons for the skeletons, so he might have trouble. And by extension, I might have trouble. I am almost contemplating just escaping both of these areas before being swarmed by the skeletons, to be quite honest with you. But this seems to work, this combo. So I will attempt. I will attempt to survive. God damn it. The halberds. I'm kind of wondering why so many of the Amazon's weapons are just everywhere in great numbers. But then again, if you see what the enemies are usually actually using the dwarfs open, I think, especially the orcs and the goblins. They are using like all sorts of sharp axes, war axes and such. Okay, yeah, this is going slightly terribly, but that might be just because I am playing with almost no sound, so that it doesn't echo in my recording, in my voice, and half the time I cannot really tell if I hit someone or if they hit me. And if there are skeletons coming from behind me or something. Okay, that was better. There is a bunch of them waiting here. Ah, they're stuck inside each other, that's cool. Come on, do the move. Oh yes, you can barely approach these guys when there's two of them. Like this. Okay, you know what? I have still one potion to return to. Kill each other, please. At least one of you kill the other one. In the Tombs of Ephira, I once got stuck inside a skeleton. You know those four skeletons of suspiciously low levels that attack you when you enter the tomb, the queen's tomb, I think, at least the place where the statue is, and you put the fetish in the place. Before you can put the fetish, if you already have it, four skeletons come out of the walls. And when they jump, if you stay in the place where they jump to, you can get stuck inside them, and neither of you will actually... The skeleton will sometime be able to hit you, but you won't be able to hit him under any circumstance. At least when you're playing as the Amazon, as I was. Okay, quick sped up part when I run for the potion. Alright. The second part, just like the first one, is down here. I don't remember where we actually exit. Unlike the previous part with the lift, but I remember that you jump down here. Let's grab the key item while we can. Yeah. Once again, skeletons finish each other before I can get the experience. Oh well. That's terrible. Everything is terrible. Barbarian. You should not be embarking on adventures which involve any sort of combat. Because that's like the one thing that you suck at completely. This kind of thing is why I hate lock-on systems and prefer direct control over my position with the mouse, like in Crusaders of Rune, over stuff that Dark Souls or this game do. Because you know your character is going to miss due to some technicality, some stupid fucking shit that's the game's fault or not yours. Or, I mean, and not yours. And that's just horrible. I mean, it's helpful for complete idiots like kids who... Like the lowest common denominator, because they probably have trouble just hitting anything without lock-on, or they're playing on consoles, which are just terrible in every way because they don't have a keyboard and mouse. Okay, wrong way. But if you make a PC game, or at least like a port, please, please, for the love of everything that's holy and unholy, depends on which way you swing, I guess, make it possible for me to rotate my character and the camera at the same time, just like this. And B, make it as direct as possible. I mean, when you have the mouse, it's practically a sin, or at least a capital crime, to not utilize it. Because it's the best freaking control device there is for any sort of precision. Anyway, we've got both recesses now. Well, actually no, we got amulets. Recesses are here. And we gotta go insert the amulets into the recesses. When I hear the word recess, I only think about the like break time in school. And here, if you want to insert the second one, no matter which order you do it, you need to actually select it in the inventory for some reason. For some unholy reason. Alright, now here is the challenge, if I remember correctly. I might actually not be remembering correctly, and this might not be the challenge, like, at all. Actually, I'm pretty sure it's not the challenge, but it's a challenge. Well, these guys. I still love his model, especially that bunch of skulls in his side, which is on the other side, so you can see it actually here, but... Okay, he has the key, by the way. Also, he is absolutely useless. And this is the one instance where an enemy drops a key, but... I mean, drops the key and you do not get it directly into your inventory. Opal key. That's all for this level, by the way. There are some pieces that got stuck up there because I guess they collided with something and decided that it was a stopping point or something. But this level is done. Let's grab key and just say goodbye to the barbarian for now.
This is Burr, the white gem, an opal of perfect purity. Guardian of the Tomb of the Sword, mounted in crystal cut from the rock as a symbol of the purity of the eternal snows of the frozen mountains.
I wonder if he's going to repeat that same line in the map screen. Let's see. I don't remember.
Treachery and perfidy have reached as far as the icy fortress, and its inhabitants have fallen under the dominion of a powerful demon and lost their reason. But Burr, the white gem, has been saved, and mounted in ice, it returns all its purity.
Alright, that was actually slightly different. And yeah, that was that. Next time, the Amazon visits the Oasis of Nijeb. Probably one of the two my favorite levels aesthetic-wise, or three or so, well, some. No, actually four, maybe even more, I don't know. There's a lot of levels in this game that I like a lot. And the terrible controls and other stuff that I don't like about this game doesn't prevent me from enjoying the good parts, which are still plentiful, don't get me wrong. This game is good overall, I would recommend it, of course. Provided you don't choose the barbarian or the dwarf, of course, but still, well, you know that. You have better sense than to pick those characters your first time through. I trust in you guys. For now, thank you for watching, see you next time, and goodbye.